I synced it when I was 12 years old. Everybody in the community used to talk about it. He said, don't go outside after dark. Don't go into the woods because the lizard man will get you. Now, boy, I can tell you, I seen the lizard man myself. A few years ago, I was hunting right here in our swamps, backwoods right here in Louisiana. Probably about 5 or 6 o'clock in the evening. Me and Jimmy, you know, my hunting partner, you know, this is usually the time where we go and hunt geese, and alligator, and deer, and different things like that. So, you know, we're walking through the dense woods towards one of our spots where we can get a good range on any deer that kind of cross past this open field down there by about 20 feet down the hill. And as we reach the top of the hill, we notice, you know, usually when deer hang out, there ain't no deer today. So I tell Jimmy, looks like there ain't no deer today. We're going to come back in the end. There ain't going to be no deer soup. So we stay there about 30 minutes. Sun comes down, and we say, better start packing and get going before it gets too dark. So we're packing up our gear, start walking back to the car. Kind of hear this loud shriek. Like, imagine 10 people screaming all at once. It was kind of like a, and we kind of both looked at each other like, what the hell is that? Now, we've been in these woods for all our lives. We never heard anything like that before. So we kind of got our extra senses to us. We extra cautious as far as, you know, what's around us. So out the corner of my eye, I kind of see something dark past. Dart past us. I'm like, hey, Jim, I think I might have seen something right there. It was kind of big. It was kind of like something I ain't never seen before. So, kind of shined our headlights over here where we saw the movement and saw a reflection. Glowing red eyes. Dark ruby glowing red eyes. It was something like I ain't never seen before. So I kind of shouted, hey, who's there? And about 20 seconds later, you see it come out into the clearing. It was about 10 feet tall, green scales, long tail, sharp teeth, had a little bit of horn right here on the top of his forehead. I looked at Jim, I said, my dog, I think that might be the lizard man. And Jim said, damn, that's the lizard man. We always heard stories like, don't go into the woods after dark because a lizard man gonna get you. And by God, them stories became reality. I aimed my rifle at the lizard man and took a shot, hit it, kind of let out another little shriek like, kind of went back into the woods, scurried back off into the woods, and me and my partner hightailed out of there like we'd been seeing the Holy Ghost or something. Got into our car and started the engine. And I looked back and I see it running full speed ahead towards us. And I said, put the gas on, Jimmy. This man gonna get us. So we put the gas, put the pedal to the metal, got skirted out of the air, and, you know, went from 0 to 60 in about 10 seconds. We drove off that little wide road out the woods going 6 miles per hour. We ain't leave nothing but dust in our trails. And then I synced it right next to our car, running full speed right next to us with these glowing red eyes looking at me. And I said, God dang, the lizard man's going to get us. Jim, what we going to do? And we both start yelling and screaming. I pick up my phone and I call the police and say, sir, we getting chased by the lizard man. We don't know what to do. You know, and the police said, y'all must be drunk or something, talking about y'all being chased by a lizard man. And I said, oh no, man, it's for real. And they kind of just laughed at us and, you know, hung up the phone. So so all we could do was drive fast, and then about 30 seconds later, it just kind of took off. Yeah, boy, I tell you, that was my Lisbon mannequin, that's for sure. Last time I'm ever going.